Hello dear students, so in the last video we were discussing about the examples for debiting and crediting under English system. So that too we have discussed one example regarding what we have to debit and what we have to credit. So let us see in the today's video, so the some more examples regarding debiting and crediting under English system. So that is the reason I am standing before the camera along with my camera technician Mustafa Pagi. Let us see the second example, dear students. So as you have already discussed the rules for debit and credit under English system. I repeat once again. So there are three types of accounts. One is personal account, another one is real account, another one is nominal account. How to say the debit and credit under personal, under real, under nominal account as per English system. So even though we have studied rules for debiting and crediting under American system also, later on we will work on that. So now I am very much interested, so that I am providing some examples regarding debiting and crediting under English system. So as per the personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. As per the real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. As per the nominal account, debit expenses or losses, credit incomes or gains. See here some examples. Example number second, I hope. Withdrawn. Cash of rupees 5000 for personal use, or you can say for domestic use. By observing this rough book entry, dear students, please concentrate. Withdrawn cash, or it may be withdrawn goods for domestic use. Here the owner has withdrawn the cash of rupees 5000 for his personal use. From the business, the owner has withdrawn the money. So, as I have said in the earlier, while maintaining the books of accounts, here we need to assume we are just an accountant of the organization. So here we are working on behalf of organization. Organization is the legal person. We people are the representative person of the organization. Here the owner is, he is a separate, he is just investor. Here we are working regarding the business only. As I said, we are the representative person of the business. In this entry, in this workbook entry, in this example, or you can say in this transaction, the owner has withdrawn the cash of rupees 5000 from the business for his personal use. Now we need to identify the two events from this transaction. So one is, who has withdrawn the money? Here the owner has withdrawn the money for his personal use. So in his book we should not write his name. So that is the reason when he invests the money into the business, we need to use the particular word, that is capital. So when he withdraws the money from the business, so we need to say him as a drawings. This is the first event. The second event, the owner has withdrawn the money. The here cash goes out. Cash account, drawings account. Here, drawing is the owner. It comes under personal account. Look here, the cash, it is a things. So, cash is a thing which comes under real account. So, here, owner is the receiver. Here cash goes out. As per the personal account rule, debit the receiver means the drawings account is to be debited. Debit. As per the real account, the cash goes out. So as per the real account, cash goes out. That is the reason cash account is to be credit. So like this, we need to identify initially. So in the two events, so we need to classify them. So we need to apply their rules. Then only we can interpret whether they are debit or credit. So like this, this is the second example. So let us see one more example, that is third. So very important example. So I would like to remove here. The third example about this one, debiting and crediting under English system. Look here. So very important transaction, that is third. Purchased goods of rupees 1000. Just here I am giving some examples. Purchased goods of rupees 1000. So observe this book entry, dear students. In this entry, they have provided purchased goods of rupees 1000 means here we have purchased the goods worth rupees 1000. So in this transaction, they didn't mention. So from whom we have purchased. So here they have not at all mentioned the person name, that means the seller name. Simply we have purchased. We means here the business has purchased goods worth rupees 1000. So with this, we can say directly, this is the cash purchase. Every purchase contains two types. There are two types of purchases. One is cash, another one is credit. In Kannada, you can say udri, idu nagadu. So cash purchase, credit purchase. Similarly, in the sales also, there are two types of sales. One is cash sales, another one is credit sales. Then you can identify whether it is cash purchase or credit purchase. If it is credit purchase, there will be the seller name who has sold the goods to us. So his name will be here. But name is not here. That is the reason here we can say this purchase is the cash purchase. So with this example, we need to identify two events. Purchase. Or you can write other than this, goods account. You can write purchase account or goods account. In the first event. In the second event, cash. Why? Because it is a cash purchase. Look here. Don't confuse yourself. If you are going to treat it is the purchase account, so as you all know, whenever you are purchase the goods, it will be an expenses. So purchase is an expenses. So purchase account, this one is goods account. So it is an expenses. Purchase is an expenses. That is the reason it comes under nominal account. So if you treat it as a goods, it comes under real account. Why? Because goods are things. Look here. So how it is nominal account? It is an expenses. How can you say it is an expenses? So whenever you have purchased the goods, so it does mean that you have spent certain money. So regarding that, we need to say it is an expenses. So if you treat the goods account, it will be a real account. So if you have purchased the goods, goods comes in. Here the commodity comes in. So look here, as for the purchase account, so it is a nominal. As for the nominal account, debit expenses or losses. That is the reason we need to debit the purchase account. Debit. If you have treated it as a goods, as per the real account, debit what comes in. So even you can take the goods, also it is to be treated as a debit as per the real account. So whether you can take the purchase account or goods account, you take any one among these. So if you have taken the purchase account, don't take this goods account, right? So one aspect we have discussed. Let us discuss the second aspect regarding the credit. So cash, as you all know, cash is the thing. It comes under real account, right? So if you have paid certain money, means cash goes out. Cash goes out. So as per the real account, credit what goes out. This is the example for so cash purchases. Okay dear students, so let us see one more example. That is fourth example. In this fourth example, just I would like to change or somewhat I would like to add some more events regarding this example. Purchased the goods of rupees 1000 from Raju. Look here. This much only new information in that earlier example. So in this example, the person who has sold to us, they have mentioned in that book entry. Purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju. So from Raju we have purchased. So in this transaction they have mentioned the name of the seller. So that is the reason it is to be treated as credit. So why? Because so from credit purchase only, in the event of credit purchase only, we do write his name in our books of account. So that is the reason it is to be treated as credit purchase. So by identifying two events, the first one is, here I am going to take only purchase account. You can take goods account, that I have already explained. The second unit, second event, Raju's account. This much is quite different. Look here, second one, purchase account is nominal account. Why? Because it is an expenses. Purchase is an expenses. Then the last one, so as per the nominal account, it is to be debit. Look here, point number B. Raju is a personal account. Raju is the giver. So Raju's account is to be credited. Like this, we need to interpret these two events. So one is debit, another one is credit, as per the debit double entry principles in the rule of English system. So let us see fifth example. Here I am changing light in this example. Okay. So leave it. This is the fifth example. Purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju for cash. Here I am adding some more event in that rough book entry. So look here, The first one, firstly, it was purchased goods. Of rupees 1000. So secondly, purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju. Thirdly, now it is purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju for cash. Look here, this is the cash purchase. Sorry. The first example is the cash purchase. Why? Because the name of the seller is not mentioned. In the second example, the name of the seller is mentioned. So regarding that, it is credit purchase. Thirdly, even though they have mentioned the Raju's name, but in the transaction, finally or lastly, they have mentioned this transaction is for cash transaction. So that is the reason we need to examine this book entry like this. So first event is similar, purchase account. So it comes under nominal account. Why? Because purchase is an expenses. As per the nominal account, it is to be debited. In this example, I am not going to write Raju's name. Why? Because so this is a cash transaction. So purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju for cash. So for that, here I have paid cash for the purchases. That is the reason. So when you have paid the cash, no need to write the purchase seller's name. That is the reason. So I am going to write the cash account. Cash is real account. Cash goes out. Finally, it is to be credit. Okay, dear students. So now we can see one more example in this aspect, that is sixth example. I'll show you how it will be. The sixth example. In the sixth example, the examiner gives like this: purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju on credit. Actually, it was not required, but the examiner has provided on credit. This much is enough for credit purchases. But even though that, he is providing on credit in the last part of the rough book entry. The example sixth is the transaction that book entry is, look here, purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju on credit. So it means this transaction is credit. Look here. So fourth one, purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju on credit. So in the event of purchase, we can see, so this one is a cash, this one is also credit. In the event of purchase, we can see four examples like these four rough book entries. So one is purchased goods of rupees 1000. Second one is purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju. What is the difference between these two rough book entries? Only from whom we have purchased. The name of the seller is mentioned. That is the reason it is credit purchase. Look here, purchased goods of rupees 1000 from Raju for cash. So along with this, so there is a quite a difference between these two examples is for cash. Okay, so now, that is the reason we need to say it as a cash purchase, even though they have mentioned the seller's name. So lastly, they have provided for cash. That is the reason it is a cash purchase. So finally, it is purchased goods of ₹1,000 from Raju on credit. So on a credit means it is a credit purchase. So when it is to be credit purchase, so the first part is same. So it is the purchase account. So purchase account comes under nominal account. As for the nominal account, it is an expenses. So now it is to be debited. So this is not a cash purchase. So we need to remove this example. Instead of this, we need to write, so it is a credit purchase. So if it is credit purchase from whom we have purchased, the name of the seller is to be right. Raju's account. He comes under personal account. So here we have purchased the goods or commodities from the Raju. Means, so not yet given the cash to him. So simply he has provided the goods to us. He is the giver. Raju is the giver. As for the personal account, credit the giver. So please concentrate on these four events, on the purchase. Whether it is cash or credit. Very important point, dear students, please keep in mind, in the transaction they have mentioned the name of the seller. After that, we need to concentrate whether it is the on cash or on credit. So if it is not provided, simply they have mentioned purchased goods of ₹1,000 from Raju, it is, look here, it is the credit purchase. So here, along with that name of the seller, they have provided on credit. Particularly, they have mentioned the word on credit. So then here we need to write Raju's account. Raju comes under personal account. Raju is the giver. As per the personal account, credit the giver. So that is the reason here I have credited the Raju's account. So like this. So I have given some examples regarding the cash, whether it is cash purchase or it is credit purchase. With this, I would like to conclude the today's video. In the next video, we will discuss regarding the sales transactions. See you on next video.